If you'd like to know how to get over a broken heart and how to move on from someone you love or loved with a sense of ease and inner peace, then this is the right video for you. I'll be sharing four of the most powerful ways to not only recover from a breakup, these four tips will also allow you to thrive in life and love, so please watch to the end. If you've just gone through a breakup, you're probably feeling pretty overwhelmed with emotions. And depending on why the relationship ended and who ended it, you may have conflicting emotions from sadness, anger, grief, relief, loss, loneliness, rejection, betrayal, and confusion. While these kinds of emotions are very normal, if your beliefs and feelings around your relationship and the breakup are not looked at, the recovery time can drag on. Instead of healing, your hurts are left to fester, which can greatly impact your future relationships and everyday joy. This is not to say that getting over an ex is going to be a walk in the park, especially when the relationship was significant and meaningful. What I am saying is that I'm here to help you get out of the storm so that you can keep on sailing. So if right now you can feel your heart constricting each time you think of your ex, or you're having trouble eating or sleeping, or maybe all you want to do is hide under the covers and escape from the world forever, then stay with me as I teach you how to move on from someone you love. Hi, I'm Nadine Peart, a dating, confidence, and lasting attraction coach for smart, savvy women and the founder of Healthy You, Healthy Love. Now, before we continue, please be sure to comment below and let me know if there's anything specific that you'd like help with and if there's a topic you'd like me to do a video on. I want to find out about who you are and what your needs are so I can support you on your path to big, sexy, and united love. And if you're new and haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please click the subscribe button and the bell button to get notified of my next video, and don't forget the thumbs up. Now, I've given plenty of breakup advice to my clients over the years, and while it may feel like healing your heart is the hardest thing to do in the world right now, I want to assure you that it's not impossible. There's a process involved in healing a broken heart, and here are three steps to do it. Number one, don't play the blame game. Whether you're pointing your finger at your ex or at yourself, playing the blame game only breeds feelings of hatred towards another or yourself. Hating is such a waste of valuable energy, and it only moves you further away from healing. And when you blame another or yourself, that is all about the ego. You can't blame another person for how you're feeling. You have control over this. Your ego does not have to rule you. Remember that the ego is not your true self. This is your reacted, triggered self who has momentarily lost touch with the core of who you are. Rather than blaming and shaming, your energy is better spent on forgiving yourself, forgiving your ex, and moving on. Whatever it is that you think you did to them or you believe that they did to you, I guarantee you that it's not as personal as you might feel. Remember that the way someone treats you says more about them than it does about you. In fact, most people don't set out to hurt people. And if they do, then why would you want to be with that person? So don't blame, don't condone. Start defining your values so that you can start to make more effective and healthy love choices. Focus on learning about yourself, how you've been doing relationships, and start to heal from the ground up. And most importantly, never forget about your gorgeous, mighty, innate worth. You are 100% worthy. You are good enough, and you are valuable with or without a partner. You are still 100% worthy even when someone is unkind towards you, or you feel you made a mistake or stuffed something up. You are still worthy. When you know this, you not only change how you feel about yourself, the way you see and treat others changes too. Compassion starts to rise within you and your heart starts to heal. Number two, the superficial hook. Have you ever dated someone or been in a relationship with someone who you knew deep down was no good for you, but somehow you just couldn't break up? Did you ever think that maybe you got hooked? You see, there are several ways that people might get hooked to someone. First is the physical hook, where people love how someone looks. They're just so attracted to them, regardless of whether their personalities or values are aligned. They feel enchanted by their physicality, by the aesthetics. Second is the sexual hook, where the physical connection is amazing, even mind-blowing, and yet the heart is not satisfied, just the body. It feels so good to be with them only at that moment, yet it feels so empty, and the rest of the time, there's little to no connection. The third is getting hooked to money, security, or lifestyle. If you're hooked to someone this way, it means you're staying with him even though you're not happy because of what that person can offer you, whether that's money or career opportunities or following a certain lifestyle. The last hook is number three, the 10% hook. This tip is so darn important as it's the root of so much unnecessary pain. Even if you've been broken up for a number of weeks, this can play on your psyche and your ability to heal and move on. The 10% hook means that you were or still are hooked to the way a man makes you feel just once in a while. Perhaps he was thoughtful and sweet when you first met. You loved how this felt, you felt so united, and this hooked you in. But when things became more serious, once he believed that he had got you, he was no longer as affectionate, attentive, or mindful of your needs. 90% of the time, he was not invested in building a healthy relationship, and there was no true partnership. What you have to know is that this type of relationship can be likened to a person who's addicted to a drug, say cocaine. In fact, this kind of relationship addiction activates the same parts of the brain. Simplistically, you love that high. You love those moments that feel so good, so connected, so delicious, but most of the time you feel horrible. And yet, at some stage, you know he will offer you that next drug hit and be loving and attentive again. And just when you think you've had enough and about to give up, he gives you another taste of the best of him and the cycle begins again. This dynamic after a breakup can be particularly conflicting because oftentimes when they know they have or may have lost you, they can become extra loving and attentive to get you back. But then as soon as they get comfortable again, they drop the ball and you're back to the 10%. Does this sound familiar? If so, please comment below and let me know your journey with this kind of relationship. That's why I call this the 10% hook. You're only hooked to the 10% of who he is or was. There's only a tiny percentage or part of your relationship that worked. And this is also why the heartbreak that follows can be painful. You know how loving the object of your affection can be, and until you truly value and love you and unhook yourself for good, you can live in the hope that they will one day love you completely and you'll finally get that 90%. Sure, no relationship is perfect 24/7, and yet in a healthy relationship, both people are invested and committed to making it work together. If you want to be in a committed and compatible relationship that's free of unnecessary heartache and drama, then unhook yourself from relationships that don't bring you consistent mutual support and kindness. Being anxiously attached to someone is never healthy, so get real and honest and cut those unhealthy cords. Don't invest in the 10%, invest in the 90%. If you're having a hard time letting go of this kind of attachment, or you know that you're struggling to be positive about men and love, then I've created something special for you. If you haven't yet, check out my free powerful quiz. It will reveal if you have some love blocks standing in the way of you attracting a healthy relationship with a loving and relationship-ready man. The quiz reveals if you're experiencing one of what I call the four romantic love syndromes. If you're serious about finding the love you want, then the link to my eye-opening free quiz is below in the description. Now, here's my last piece of breakup advice. Number four, I want you to get sexy with life. Relationships can have us losing our sense of self, and heartbreak can take the wind out of our sails. The best thing to do is to know how to put the wind back into your very own sails. And a really, really good way to do this is to get sexy. Now, if thoughts of buying sexy lingerie and seduction popped into your mind, that's all well and good, though this isn't exactly the kind of sexy I'm referring to. This is not about finding yourself a rebound man to help you get over the breakup, far from it and generally not advised. I'm talking about getting sexy with life in general. Flirting with life is one of those things most people don't do enough of. I realize if you've literally just broken up with someone, you'll need a number of days or even a few weeks to process your feelings, though most people wallow in this for far too long and forget that there is so much more to life and that one relationship does not define them. There comes a time when we need to shift our perspective and rise into life. Sometimes we don't even realize it that we've started a pity party and we need to break this narrative. So what does it mean to get sexy or flirt with life? There is an infinite amount of ways to do this. It's really about being more present in the moment and finding joy in the little things. For example, the way you eat a piece of fruit or a meal can be done with more presence and appreciation. Talking to a friend can be done from a lighter, more joyful place. So can dancing, singing, laughing, writing, cleaning, exercising, dressing, and doing your makeup. Getting sexy with life means being more passionate and more appreciative about everything you do. Start loving you in every way. For instance, if you're walking around the grocery store, instead of seeing it as a chore, you can choose to see it as a lovely way to buy healthy food, to nourish your body, and to love you. That's sexy. If you're chatting with a friend and you often over-talk and don't listen all that well, or you tend to say very little, then do the opposite. That's getting sexy with communication. This may sound weird, but trust me, it works. So go out there and get sexy with your life. So there you have it, four beautiful ways to heal from a bad breakup and heartbreak early on. So rather than being tempted to drink away your sorrows, pick up random men to feel wanted and loved, or call your ex, I suggest you work on these four things first. Because how to move on from someone you love is always to love and honor yourself first. Like I said earlier, it may feel difficult for you today, but everyone can overcome a broken heart. When you stop living in the past and stop taking things personally, then life and love feels lighter and lovelier. Forgive him, forgive yourself, and free yourself from unhealthy attachment and flirt with life. If you struggle with understanding and processing your emotions, or you often find yourself hooked to the wrong men, then my program, Never Lose Him, is brilliant for this. I reveal some powerful tools to help you rise above the pain and confusion so that you can have the courage to confidently walk away from the wrong man for you and attract the most perfect man for you. I teach what I call the lips method, the ultimate magnetic attraction formula. It doesn't matter if you're shy, loud, tall, short, funny, more serious, 25 or 65 years of age. When you cultivate these traits, the best men for you will take notice of you and you'll know how to get the love you want. Finally, the link to Never Lose Him is in the description below. Well, that's it for today's video. If you haven't yet, please subscribe, comment, and give this video the thumbs up. And please share it with a friend who could use some help with getting over an ex and healing their heart. It's been a great honor to have you here with me. I encourage you to choose to show love a little more in some way every day, and see you again at my next video.